talk about a very important topic today, which is close to my heart and one of my favorite topics. Yes, body chakras. Very simple yet empowering concept. A concept that is the basis of all the creations. Jiha, body chakras. Often when people come to me, I ask them, how many chakras do we have? They say seven, and I tell them, no, 114 chakras we have. Two are outside our physical body, so inside 112 chakras. Yet we often start with seven main chakras. Now, what are these chakras? Body chakras hote kya hai? They are on our spine. And for those of you who are interested in Ayurveda or have some knowledge about yoga, you know that we have three main nadis, which are Sushumna, Ida, and Pingala. So wherever Ida and Pingala Nadi meet on Sushumna Nadi, an energy center is formed. And those seven main energy centers are our seven main chakras. Okay. Now, why is it called chakra or a body chakra? It is a funnel shaped thing, but because it revolves at a very high speed or a frequency, both clockwise and anti-clockwise, so it appears as a chakra or a wheel. In Sanskrit, chakra means wheel. So if anything which is funnel shaped and rotating at a very high speed and you see it from the far, it will appear to you as a chakra. Hence it is known as body chakra. Now, every chakra has got a Hindi name or a Sanskrit name and an English name. It has a color assigned to it and it has a specific purpose. So if our channels or our body chakras are open and balanced, we can enjoy good health, abundance, prosperity and harmonious relationships in our life along with spiritual ascension or spiritual growth. So the first chakra is near our genitals. It is known as a Mooladhara chakra or a root chakra because it's at the spine of the, at the bottom of the spine. So root or Mooladhara, because it's the mool or the base of your entire body, entire spine. It's there. So Mooladhara, and the color is red. And it is for your materialistic benefits. Okay. All the house, car, money, promotion, all these things, money and your survival instinct, okay, your safety and security. So essentially Mooladhara chakra takes care of that. So if in your life you are struggling with career or finance, then it might be a possibility that your Mooladhara chakra is not balanced. It can be either underactive or overactive. Both are not good. It has to be balanced. Like everything in life needs a balance. So how you can balance chakras is another topic. You can do it through crystals. You can do it through meditation or Reiki. Okay. Now when you move 2 inches above, that is where is your Swadhisthana or your sacral chakra. The color for this is orange. This chakra basically is for your man-woman relationship or man-to-man or woman-to-woman, whatever your sexuality is. This is basically for your sexuality. And also the entire reproductive system of a woman is there. If you look at all the organs, it's there, very much there. So couples who are planning a family, this chakra becomes very important. If you are trying to get married or looking for a soulmate, this chakra has a relevance. If you have issues in your marriage or your relationship with your partner, or you want to make your romantic relationship more romantic or harmonious, then this has significance. Also, this is for your creativity. Okay, so if you want to think out of the box or become more innovative, or you are an artist and you feel you have an artistic block, you want to click good pictures or paint well, or maybe you have good paintings but they are not selling, you know, so this chakra comes into picture. Then you move on 2 inches further up near your belly button or your navel, nabhi par. That is where your Manipura, money, yeah, that's the money, because our life and death is programmed there, okay? So Manipura chakra or your solar plexus chakra. यहीं पर तीर मारने से रावण जो है मरे थे राम के, है ना, तो वो लाइफ एंड डेथ प्रोग्रामिंग इज देयर. सो दैट्स योर मणिपुरा चक्र, कलर इज येलो. नाउ दिस इज फॉर आवर लाइफ एनर्जीज, आवर ऊर्जा. सो इफ इट इज अंडर एक्टिव यू विल फील लेथार्जिक इन लाइफ, यू विल हैव लॉट ऑफ इनर्शिया, यू वुड नॉट फील लाइक डूइंग एनीथिंग. इफ दिस गेट्स ओवर बैलेंस देन यू आर very anxious, you're hyperactive all the time. Especially this happens in children. When mothers come and they tell me, oh, my kid is so overactive all the time. Pooja ji, what do I do, ma'am? So we try and balance the Manipura chakra, okay? So that the extra energy gets channelized into something which is more constructive and the kid is no more hyperactive, okay? And he or she is able to do better in life. Now, also, this chakra, along with energy, brings in conversion or transformation in our life. So, if you are someone who's looking at growth or improving yourself or transforming your life or any kind of conversion in your life, it could be a promotion, so conversion into another level, or people who are dating and they want to go to the next level of the relationship, let's say marriage. So that's again conversion, okay? Business getting stuck, saturation in life, all these things, you know, where to work on your solar plexus. Then moving further up, your chest is your Anahata or your heart chakra. The color is green or pink. Now for years, I used to wonder, is it green or pink? You know, some people will say it's green in color. Some people will say it's pink in color. A lot of confusion. Initially, by default, it is green. However, as and when we practice compassion in our life through meditation or self-experiences, with more and more compassion, the green color Anahata gets transformed into pink color Anahata. Okay, so I'm very sure people like Mother Teresa, Buddha, you know, they had a pink color heart chakra. Yeah, because they were full of compassion. Mother Teresa, she dedicated her life for the humanity. Then this is for giving and receiving love. Now, love in general, not the romantic love, because your romantic love is through your Swadhisthana chakra or sacral chakra. So this is compassion, love for humanity, plant kingdom, animal kingdom, mineral kingdom, everybody. Wherever you go, people accept you, like you, love you. You're a good manager. So your team, your subordinates, they listen to you, you know, that kind of a thing. Then further, your fifth chakra is your Vishuddha. Some people call it Vishuddhi or your throat chakra. Very, very important. It's like blue in color, like Shiva, Neelakanta. Okay, the snake is there. So it gives you power. So if this chakra is balanced, usually people say that, you know, you have good communication skills and you are talkative. You can talk well. You can express yourself well. You're vocal. All that is good. You're a good orator. Yes, absolutely correct. What is more important is that it also gives you leadership quality. Okay, so if you're a CEO of a company or you're a successful politician or whatever, so you are in a leadership role, you want people to look up to you, that confidence also comes with this chakra. Then your sixth chakra is between your eyebrows, where we put Bindi or Tilak. This is your Agya chakra, Ajna chakra or third eye chakra. This makes you psychic. This gives you intuition. This helps you take the right decision at the right time. Dark blue in color. And this gives you peace, all those kind of things. Moving further up, seventh chakra is here, which is your crown chakra or your Sahasra chakra, indigo in color. This is basically your connect to the divine. And if this is open, you are open to receive the blessings and grace of universe, and all good things happen to you. Okay, so if this is closed, no matter how much positive energy I give to you, you will not receive anything. You know, often we say whenever you sit for meditation or you're in meditative position, we ask you to sit straight with your spine straight and we ask you to keep your palms or hands facing the sky. Why is it? So that you receive energy. We are making your body like an antenna, like we used to have in old days antenna for the TV. So we try and make your body's geometry, sacred geometry, in a way with your palms facing the sky, that you're open to receive the blessings or the grace from the universe. Similarly, when this chakra is open, you are open to receive the grace. Okay. which is very important. So this is about these seven main chakras. Though we do this in detail when we do Reiki and otherwise in chakra workshops also, but for now I thought let me make this video and share it with you. If you have further questions on this or if you want to clarify anything, you can always leave comments and I will reply. And this topic we can actually study for 1 week. This topic is so huge, it's like an ocean. But for now, this is a crash course. This is good. Do like the video and do share it with your family and friends, because all of us should know it. Like there's a body anatomy that we study. Similarly, we all should know these seven chakras are in everybody's body. Okay, so every human being has it. It's part of you. It's part of your system. Whether you know it or not, it's there. So we might as well know it. So share this video with everybody to create awareness. And even if you knew it already, I'm sure it'll be a good revision for you. Maybe if you did Reiki, you know, years back, and this is going to be a good revision for you. And that's it. And if you've not subscribed to the channel, make sure you do it. I mean, so that you keep receiving these interesting and videos that create awareness in your life. Do let me know what other topics you would want me to make a video on. Thanks for now. For now, I'll wrap up this video and I'll come back again with more interesting videos. Time to go now. Namaste.